Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about the gradient vector. And in this problem, we've been asked to find the maximum directional derivative, which is also called the gradient vector, and the direction in which it occurs. So we'll be finding direction first and then finding the maximum directional derivative. So in order to find the direction, we're going to need to find the gradient vector at the point P. And the way that we do that, the way that we find the gradient vector, is by taking the partial derivatives of f with respect to x and y, and then plugging in the point P. So the gradient vector we denote in this way, and it's also called the maximum directional derivative. So the gradient vector is going to be this upside down triangle here, f of xy, and that's going to be the partial derivatives with respect to x and y. So it's going to be like this, the partial derivative of f with respect to x and the partial derivative of f with respect to y. So let's first go ahead and find both of those partial derivatives. The partial derivative of f with respect to x, remember when we take the partial derivative of f with respect to x, we're treating x as the variable and holding y constant. So we'll take the derivative term by term. The derivative of 2x squared will be 4x. The derivative of 3xy will be 3y. And the reason, remember, is because when we're taking the derivative with respect to x, right, if we just took the derivative of x, we would get 1. So we'd end up with 1 times 3y, which of course just gives us 3y. So the derivative of that term with respect to x is 3y. The derivative of 4y squared is 0 because there's no x term involved in, there's no x variable involved in that term, so the derivative is 0. If we take the partial derivative of f with respect to y term by term, the derivative of 2x squared will be 0 because again there's no y variable involved in that term. The derivative of 3xy will be 3x, and the derivative of 4y squared will be 8y. So these are our two partial derivatives, and we can now plug them into the gradient vector to give us the maximum directional derivative. So plugging them in here, we'll get 4x plus 3y and 3x plus 8y. Now we need to, in order to find the direction of this, plug in the point 1, 1. So that'll give us f of 1, 1. Plugging that in, 1 for x and 1 for y, we'll get 4 times 1, which is just 4, plus 3 times 1, which is 3, comma, 3 times 1 is 3, plus 8 times 1 is 8, and when we simplify this, obviously we get 7, comma, 11. Now this is the direction in which the maximum directional derivative or the gradient vector occurs. So remember we were asked to find the direction and the maximum directional derivative. We have found the direction with this. Now, finding the maximum directional derivative or the gradient vector is as simple as taking our answer here, 7, 11, and doing the following. We're going to take first, actually, let's assume that this vector here is a, b, right? We've got 7, 11. Basically, this is a, b. And if you have three variables, if we had 7, 11, 8, it would be a, b, and c. But right now, we've just got two variables, 7 and 11. We would plug them in here in the square root as 7 squared plus 11 squared. And again, if we had a third vector, we called it c, we could add that c squared term under the square root as well. But in this case, we just have the two. So 7 squared plus 11 squared is going to be equal to the square root of 49 plus 121, which is going to be equal to the square root of 160, 170. So the square root of 170, and this is going to be the maximum directional derivative. So again, the square root of 170 is the maximum directional derivative, and it occurs in the direction 7, 11 here. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.